Look, there's a lot of shows that fall under the broad category of quote-unquote underrated. Some of them are justified, some of them are not, but I think there's something to be said for a show that's not really underrated, but under-acknowledged. And that's how I feel about C.H. Greenblatt's chaotic masterpiece, Chowder. Chowder isn't underrated, okay? We all remember this show, let's be honest. It still pops up in the timeline every once in a while. There's a rap song on the radio about it, but I don't think people realize just how incredible Chowder was or how much it did for the animation industry. And that's what I want to talk about today, guys. I'm Nemo, and I want to tell you how Chowder changed everything. To tell the story of Chowder, we need to tell the story of its creator, a charming man named C.H. Greenblatt. The man had humble origins, being born in Texas, where he actually went to school for advertising before pursuing a career in animation, which definitely just seems like the better option. Not a lot of people get to start off in glamorous positions, but his first gig in the animation game was on a little-known cartoon called SpongeBob SquarePants. Imagine the first cartoon you work on being one of the most influential and biggest cartoons of all time. That's crazy to me. C.H. Greenblatt actually had a pretty big part to play in SpongeBob and did a lot of important episodes, but I think one of his most notable has to be Fear of a Krabby Patty. That episode produced so many memes and just meme SpongeBob faces, and C.H. Greenblatt, a storyboarder on that episode, actually had a big role in a lot of those faces. The man creates memes, he's a legend. He worked on SpongeBob for a while before eventually moving on to Cartoon Network, working on the equally incredible cartoon Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy. You actually might recognize his work on the show as he created one of Billy and Mandy's most iconic characters, Fred Fredberger, voiced by C.H. Greenblatt himself. That's right, the creator of Chowder also made Fred Fredberger. I remember when I first learned that, it completely blew my mind. After working on Grim Adventures for a while, he decided to pitch his own cartoon. A little idea he had been kicking around since the SpongeBob days. He wanted to make a show that was the Sorcerer's Apprentice type show, and eventually settled on the idea of a child chef studying under a master chef learning how to cook. He pitched the idea to Cartoon Network while working on Grim, and after about 2 years, they ended up picking up the show. After a year of development, the first episode of Chowder finally aired in 2007. According to C.H. Greenblatt, it took him 7 years from concept to the first episode to get Chowder made. That is a crazy long time and a ton of dedication to his idea, and it paid off. The show premiered in 2007, and by the very first episode, The Froggy Apple Crumble Thumbkin, Chowder set itself apart as being exceptionally weird. I've never seen a show, and I still haven't since, that had the kind of style that Chowder had, both visually and comedically. Let me explain. The first thing that Chowder nailed is having an incredibly unique look to it. You could pull any frame and it would look so incredibly Chowder. Even the tiniest things, like the way that the backgrounds on their clothes stay static as they walk, it's honestly beautiful. On top of that, Chowder did an incredible job of using mixed media to enhance the character of the show overall. In any given episode, you could cut to a random stop motion segment or a live action segment. It even gave us those incredibly complicated food transitions that just became a staple for the show. And don't even get me started on the character designs. What are any of the things in this show? According to C.H. Greenblatt, when he designed Chowder, he designed him with no specific animal in mind, but instead Chowder was meant to invoke the image of a child's soft plush toy, which honestly, that's just perfectly nailing it. But on top of that, what is Mung Dull? What is Schnitzel? What is Endive? I need to know. Why does Schnitzel only say Rada Rada? This show is brilliant and also weird as f***. The show centered on Chowder, a child chef studying under Mung Dull, learning how to be a master chef. They hang out with Mung Dull's other employee, Schnitzel, and deal with the constant nagging of Mung Dull's wife, Truffles, voiced by Tara Strong. I just want to take a moment to touch on how incredible the voice cast is, and not only does it have Tara Strong and John DiMaggio, with his sole purpose to just say the same phrase over and over again, but Chowder's voice actor, Nikki Jones, was just the cutest kid ever, and he did an incredible job of voicing Chowder. He really made the character come to life. I don't know, I just wanted to point out that the voice cast was another reason why I love the show so much. But despite the main four, Chowder had so many iconic characters. There, of course, was Panini, the girl who's always pining over Chowder, despite him always refusing to be her boyfriend. In fact, this is one of the biggest parts of the series, and gets revisited a lot throughout the show. Panini is also training under a chef, Endive, who was my favorite character on Chowder by far. She is this disgusting, giant, horrifying woman who is constantly doing better than Mung Dull. It's sort of like a Krusty Krab Chum Bucket situation, except instead of plankton, it's a giant woman. Then, of course, there's the lovable Gazpacho, who runs a food stand that Chowder frequently visits. A lot of Chowder's creativity comes from the weird food that it's able to come up with, and a lot of the problems and solutions in the show come from the weird food they're working with, whether it's something that's so sour Chowder gets sucked into his own mouth, or whatever the heck a purple nurple is. Chowder was definitely creative with his food, and another thing, the food always looked so good in this show. I don't know if it's just me. I think that's just like a common thing with cartoons. What's up with that? There's even Gorgonzola, who kind of acts as the antagonist of the series, though Chowder naively thinks of him as a friend, Gorgonzola despises Chowder and is constantly annoyed by his antics. The two of them often go on adventures together in unfortunate situations, like in the hilarious episode The Blackout, which is actually one of the most famous episodes of Chowder, in which the city has a blackout and it's up to Gorgonzola and Chowder along the way running into what they describe as weirdos. Not only is this one of the funniest episodes, but it's one of the strangest and the character designs are just unmatched. It makes sense Chowder is as good as it is, considering C.H. Greenblatt's track record. I mean, the other two shows he worked on were SpongeBob and Grim Adventures, two of the greatest cartoons of all time. And the humor from those two cartoons really show in Chowder in the best way. There were so many little weird, quirky things to Chowder that really made it feel like its own universe. The fact that they never had real food, but every character was named after a food. Down to the designs of the freaking buildings. The fact that everyone drove around in like snail shell cars. It was just iconically Chowder, and it was amazing. But stylistic stuff aside, I want to get down into the meat and potatoes of why Chowder was so good to so many people. This show is hilarious. And I know it's easy to call anything funny, but Chowder's funny in a way that not a lot of shows were. I would describe it as like right hook comedy, because you don't see the jokes coming, you don't expect them, you can never predict them, and they just hit you like a right hook and you're just laughing so hard. The show is goofy and at times kind of childish, but I think it balances that humor with genuinely funny writing. But what I think makes Chowder really stand out is its use of the fourth wall break. Now you see it everywhere, and I know things have done it before, it wasn't completely new, but Chowder used it to its advantage every time it could. In one of my favorite episodes ever, the shopping spree, Chowder, Mungdahl, and Schnitzel end up going on a crazy shopping spree and spending all of their money. And in turn, they actually run out of the budget for the animation, where they cut to an actual live-action segment with the four voice actors literally throwing a car wash to make more money. In what other show would they do that? Chowder is not afraid to get absurd, it's not afraid to go to the craziest lengths that it can, and it also is not afraid to make fun of itself. In the Emmy-nominated episode, The Toots, it literally opens with Chowder and Mungdahl having a conversation about how formulaic the show can be at times.
So, now what?
Well, now I should tell you not to eat it.
And I eat it anyway, right?
Yep.
It's one thing to break the fourth wall, but Chowder crafted it and used it as a tool to push the comedy so much further than any other show at the time. And this kind of weird, bizarre comedy is seen through so many other shows after. Chowder was at the forefront of this weird writing style, and it really paved the way for a lot of other shows to go into these weird territories. I mean, C.H. Greenblatt literally put himself in the show as a puppet god. Come on, how do you not love that? Chowder only ran for 3 seasons. Unfortunately, in 2010, the show was actually canceled by the network to make room for the now infamous CN Reel lineup. Great decision, buddy. We all love you for that one. Thank God Chowder ended so we could have Dude What Would Happen. Oh, joy. But the good news is that meant that Chowder got to end on a high note and actually had a series finale. They were allowed to plan the ending, and it was one of the weirdest series finales of all time. Centering on Chowder growing up and having to be an adult, and he ends up actually marrying Panini, which I feel like is a good close to the series. But even though it was canceled, I think it was better on all parties, including C.H. Greenblatt, who stated that he was grateful the show ended because his schedule freed up and he was actually happier than he'd been in a long time, which is really good to hear. Chowder came to a close in 2010, but not without making a huge impact. So what happened next? Well, C.H. Greenblatt has not stopped anytime soon. A few years after Chowder ended, he ended up going to Nickelodeon and made the show Harvey, Beaks, another incredible cartoon that ended too soon. It's kind of up in the air what he's going to do next, but I know it's going to be amazing. And like I said, Chowder's legacy is definitely intact. It's one of the most beloved cartoons of all time. A ton of people reached out asking me to make an episode on this show specifically, which shows that Chowder still resonates with so many people. Especially as its audience grows up, they're finding a new love for it, a new appreciation for what it was. Chowder is not the type of show to fade away, it's too special for that. And even now it's falling into the nostalgia territory, which pretty much puts any show at a legend status, so that's good to see. If you're looking at modern day influences of Chowder, in fact, you could look to one of the most popular cartoons of the last decade, The Amazing World of Gumball. If I had to, I would label this as the successor to Chowder. Its incredible use of fourth wall breaks, its meta comedy, its mixed medium art styles. Looking at the two innately, you might not think they're even connected, but when you start to peer deeper, you can see Chowder's influences in just about any show, Gumball especially. It literally even influenced a chart-topping rap song. I don't know what more you want. That's amazing. At the end of the day, Chowder is a perfect example that you can create a show without a super serious story, that's super one-off and goofy, and still have an incredible impact on so many people. At least that's how I feel. That's how Chowder changed everything. But as always, I want to know what you guys think about this. Do you agree with what I said? Do you hate Chowder? Why would you hate Chowder? Let us know in those comments down below, or tweet to us at Roundtable Vids, or me at StretcherNemo. If you want to consider helping out the Roundtable, you can consider becoming a member of the channel or support us on Patreon to get exclusive access to scripts and avatars. As always, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, share it, and subscribe to the Roundtable for more incredible cartoon content, guys. As always, I'm Nemo, and I'll see you next time. Peace.